There's something I'd like to show you, Captain.
Terry, crushed. It?
It works!
I've never been more proud of you for anything in your life.
I mean, I've solved a lot of cases for you.
And yet crime has continued.
Hello, Raymond.
Madeline, I wondered why all the birds had suddenly stopped singing. What brings you here?
I heard you were under investigation by Internal Affairs. Didn't want to miss that.
So much time with your ear to the pavement. It's a pity a truck hasn't run over your head.
She's worried about her motorcycle sitting idle, so she wants us to take it out once a day. Here.
I think you should do this. You're more the biker type. I've seen you use a toothpick in public.
Motorcycles are death machines. I have 3 kids. I'm not risking it.
Are you saying my life matters less because I don't conform to society's heteronormative, child-centric ideals?
Are you really playing the gay card right now?
Yes, Queen.
Looks like we've both got a pretty bad case of jerk boss.
Yes, yours is an idiot and mine is a fork-tongued lizard witch.
Whoa, what's with the cast?
I sprained my wrist.
Oh no, what happened?
Don't worry about it, I'm fine.
Yeah, geez, Amy, back off. Leave the guy alone.
All right, huddle up, everybody, bring it in. So he wouldn't say what happened, which can only mean one thing.
He's in a fight club.
No, he did it doing something he's embarrassed by, like smiling. Only question is, how do you hurt your arm smiling?
Could be a sports injury. I sprained my wrist in college playing field hockey.
Men's field hockey?
Yeah, it's much more violent than the women's game. We're not allowed to wear anything that protects our breasts.
Attention, everyone!
I can hear you speculating about the nature and origin of my injury from my office. I tripped over an uneven sidewalk. I did not think it was relevant to your jobs, the jobs which you should all be doing right now. Get to work.
Do you want to know how I actually hurt my wrist?
Yes.
I was hula hooping. Kevin and I attend a class for fitness and for fun.
Oh, my God.
I've mastered all the moves. The pizza toss, the tornado, the scorpion, the oopsie doodle.
Why are you telling me this?
Because no one will ever believe you.
No, no. You sick son of a bitch.
Lunch.
Hello, Raymond. You're looking old and sickly.
So nice of you to greet us, Madeline. I thought surely you'd still be crushed under that house in Munchkinland.
Sticks and stones, Raymond.
Describing your breakfast?
Halloween. It's heist time.
Thought you could get a head start on heist prep? Good luck. I'm already dressed.
Well, I'm also dressed, and I made breakfast. Wait, where are my eggs?
In my belly.
Yeah!
Now get a move on. It's heist time.
I love Halloween!
You're not Cheddar. You're just some common bitch.
I've come to ask for your help. The commissioner will be calling
wait,
you.
Oh, moment savored. So, where were we?
When people say good morning, they mean hello. When people say how are you, they mean hello. When people say what's up, they mean I am a person not worth talking to.
Deputy Chief Wunsch is here to see you.
Oh, please stay, Diaz. I need a witness in case her head starts spinning around or she turns into a she-wolf.
Hey, Captain. Mind if we sit?
Is everything okay?
Nothing's okay. Wunsch circling me like a shark frenzied by chum. The task force turning into a career-threatening quagmire, an internal affairs investigation casting doubt upon my integrity. And you ask, is everything okay? I am buffeted by the winds of my foe's enmity and cast about by the towering waves of cruel fate. Yet I, a captain, am no longer able to command my vessel, my precinct from my customary helm, my office. And you ask, is everything okay? I've worked the better part of my years on Earth, overcoming every prejudice and fighting for the position I hold, and now I feel it being ripped from my grasp. And with it, the very essence of what defines me as a man. And you ask, is everything okay?
Yeah, I hear you. My dog has taken over my favorite chair. It's like, how did it all slip away?
You're going to leave my precinct and my task force alone.
Or else, you're wunch meat.
You sure you want to go with that one?
Absolutely, it's hilarious.
All right.
Ah, there it is. The shriveled husk of Raymond Holt.
Look, Gina, is that a talking raisin?
Oh, I see you have a knife. But what you need is an umbrella.
Tell him why. Tell him why.
Because there's a storm gonna rain down on you, punk. You took the wrong fluffy boy.
That you came to me to ask for help shows how much you've matured. You know what else shows how much you've matured? Your withered face.
Now I know why you refer to this as a suicide squad, Peralta, because I already want to kill myself.
Why don't you wait a week? You'll probably die of old age.
The only way I'm gonna die is if you touch me with one of your bony fingers and drag me across the river Styx, you reaper.
Peralta, are you eating an Italian sub for breakfast?
I am, but Amy said I should eat more veggies, so I got extra peppercini. Smart.
Excuse me. You need to watch yourself.
I'm sorry. Cop.
All right, let's everybody just stay calm here.
Oh, what? Are you gonna arrest me for dancing?
You call that dancing? This is dancing.
What is happening?
I'm defusing the situation.
Dancing captain, let's capture an image of a lifetime. Oh, why is my phone always dead? I paid $13 for it.
Don't worry, Jacob.
I got it. Okay.
Oh, my hands are covered in butter from making butter.
I'm on it.
Must record.
Camera on.
All right, here we go.
Dancing over. Situation diffused.
No!
And what do you hope to get out of this, Madeline? Let me guess. Revenge on Dorothy for killing your sister.
I want the same as you, Raymond. I think what John Kelly is doing is terrible.
Yes, well said, Wunsch. So we're all on board. This is exciting. Let's bring it in, huh? Suicide Squad on three. Ready? One, two.
I don't touch other dudes' hands.
Whose hand is sticky?
Oh, that might be me. I ate a popsicle earlier.
It's probably Madeline. Cockroaches release a mucus-like secretion.
She will leave the city, the clouds will part, and the children will sing Wunsch is gone.
What children?
All the children.
Right, that was a stupid question.
I got her a parting gift.
Tickets to Wicked?
In Boston. She's moving to a second-class city, and I wanted to rub her nose in it. Enjoy the understudies, Madeline. Have fun watching some chubby Chenoweth knockoff warble her way through popular.
What's this meeting about? Did someone find my meatball sub?
A, we would never have a meeting about that. B, you are holding it.
Oh. Meeting adjourned.
Meeting's not over, dummy. Terry said he has some news from the office of Commissioner Wunsch.
Ugh, what does that human blister want now? Does she intend to demote me even further? Or perhaps she'll transfer me to the swamps of New Jersey so I can patrol the sinkhole where she was spawned.
Or it's possible the announcement has nothing to do with you.
Oh, good thinking, Peralta. You're right. Maybe Madeline wants to inform us all that she's a chooksin.
A what?
A chooksin, a Korean toilet ghost. Lives in an outhouse, wraps her hair around your throat, and chokes you to death while you move your bowels.
You know what? I will give you $6,000 if the announcement is she's a chooksin.
Okay, everyone, I have some news.
That Madeline Wunsch is a Korean toilet ghost? Boring. We already knew that.
Madeline Wunsch is dead.
Say what now?